Welcome back to Let's Replay Pokémon Colosseum. Last time, we saved Rui from a bunch of thugs, and kinda had two introductory battles to what's to come. And as we can see, most of the battles here in Aura will be double battles, and actually that's pretty much every battle. But before we head off to the mayor like we're actually supposed to, if you talk to this old man, which I'm pretty sure a lot of people probably did or didn't on their first run, what fine weather this is! It is truly a perfect sort of day for a Pokémon battle! So young one, how about indulging this old man? Let us battle! This actually surprised me. I had no idea you can battle this old man. So yeah, we're gonna get on that. Fun old man Derek would like to battle. This is what kind of confused me as of late. Did not know you can battle him. So yeah, this is actually kind of fun. Just a little awkward though. You wouldn't expect to see an old man with Pokemon. Then again, it's Pokemon. Anything is possible in the world of Pokemon. Right, who isn't any psychic type? At least I think not. I hope not. No, it's not a lot of fun. I haven't played Pokemon in a while, so my typing's a little iffy if it comes to Pokemon type, so. The ones I'm definitely sure of is that Umbreon Star type Espeon is psychic, because even though if Espeon evolves in the sun, it should be like light types. But then again, Nintendo does not want to put a light type in there, which would have made a little bit more sense for Reshiram in the more recent games, Dragon and Light, and Zekrom being Dragon and Dark. But they're supposed to be like yin and yang type deals. I don't know why am I even thinking about this right now. Well, I've got to concede this one, lad. And he gives us 800 Poké for that. The old man's loaded. Ah, yes. You're young, but you've got a bit of spine. Ah, you're just like me when I was young. Well done indeed. And there's only one of a few battles we can have here in the city. I don't think you can battle her. I think people who are like standing still you can battle. I'm not so sure. The game confuses me with its trainers these days. And if you go back here, you'll find a kid with rollerblades, I'm thinking. I'm no good at score, but I'm pretty hot at Pokemon battles. You're a trainer too, aren't you? Let's duke it out. Let's battle. And we're going to accept because Pokemon battles are fun. Even though it's essentially cockfighting. Alright, here we come. There's no holding back. So yeah, Rollerblade Kaiba. I think that's how you pronounce that name. And he has a Wurmple and a Silphian. Oh hey, Espeon, you're a beast here, because these are bug types, and bug types like to die to psychic, apparently. Not even Umbreon sounds that much better. Actually, dark types are immune to psychics, aren't they? I think so. They're also like super effective against ghosts and psychic types, so that's where Umbreon has the upper hand on Espeon plays. Espeon can't hurt dark types, but Espeon can beat the crap out of ghost and fighting types, which Umbreon cannot. Umbreon can't beat up fighting types, but he can beat up the other type that's currently out of my head right now. And Wurmple refused to die to a bite attack from a dog. Essentially, that's what I think the Eevee evolutions are, like a bunch of dogs. Dogs have like multiple different breeds that evolve throughout time and space and quantum continuum. So it makes sense that Eevee would be like the dog species of this game. Okay, Espeon leveled up. I don't know, my head's it's like really just gone right now. Ouch, no, that wasn't supposed to happen. And you get oh man, kid, you are weak. You are poor as crud. I'm sorry, that is poor. Man, that is poor. He had no money on him. That is poor. I didn't think I'd lose. Big guy, you're tough. I want you to have this since you're so good. And we attain TM41. Now, I believe that... Okay, that's Torment. Prevents Pokemon from using the same move twice in a row. I would like to use that on Pokemon, but I think it wouldn't really do me any good in the long run. Because I'm not really one for more so stat-afflicting things. but more so, I'm more of the full-on onslaught type guy. I don't really go for stat-reducing moves or anything like that. But before I do anything else, I'm going to heal and save because I can, and I shall. And it's very easy to overwrite a Pokemon game by just starting a new game and then saving. I'm just really hoping that this memory card does not, like, die on me, like, halfway through the recording and I have to use my old one. Because that would be a pain. You know, I miss the good old item storage. Too bad I never even had the need to use it. Because I normally sell off my stuff before I actually end up with too much space. Rather, too many items in my inventory, but whatever. And the kid's running with his cast form again. That's awesome. The cast form is a nice touch, but I'm not one for cast form. Hi, old lady. Large houses. These houses are all technically large, lady, so you're going to have to specify. Visit the mayor's house for his advice. Eh, I don't know. I guess you're a traveling trainer. I like what I see in your expression. I have a feeling I may see you again somewhere. I don't think I like him too much. And if you talk to the old lady... Yep. Even she reacts to that. That dude has some freaky hairstyle too. Oh, I know why his house is so large. It has a second floor. I think the mayor's house is the only one that actually has a second floor. Beats me.
Ah, you must be traveling trainers. Welcome to Phenac City. I am Escalade, the mayor. Are you wanting to see me? Is there something I may be able to assist you with? Oh, what may I do for a pretty young lady like you?
I saw it.
Saw it?
What did you see, young lady?
I saw a peculiar Pokemon. No, that's not quite right. What I saw was a Pokemon that gave off a black aura. It was like a fighting machine. And that Pokemon would attack people.
Oh my. Pokemon like a fighting machine? And it attacks people? I've never heard of it. Now, if that were true, that would truly be frightening. However, it is a little hard to believe.
It's true. It's true, Mr. Mayor. Because I saw that Pokemon, I was made the prisoner of some frightening man until just a little while ago.
I see. I understand. I will order an investigation at once.
You will? Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Oh, no. There is no need for thanks. We mustn't allow thugs to do as they wish, especially thugs that endanger a pretty young lady like you. I'll ask that you give me a little time on this matter. I promise we will get some useful information for you. Oh, yes. You appear to be Pokemon trainers yourselves. If so, I urge you to visit our city's pride and joy, our Pokemon Stadium. It is a breathtakingly beautiful stadium befitting our Oasis City.
I don't think I quite trust him, Wes. I don't trust him at all. You're not the only one. And to make Wes seem not so silent, you know, give him some just random quotations here and there to make him at least have somewhat of a personality. Instead of being the blank slate, oh hey, I was bad, let's go do good things now. But, the Colosseum. I want to go battle. This is where we register training for challenges. However, the current challenge has already started, so we are no longer accepting trainers for this challenge. Please come back and enter next year. Well, that was a waste of our time. You know, Wes, I don't think I quite like your attitude. Shut up.
Hey, Dark, we finally found you, you filthy double-crossing traitor. Wrecking our hideout wasn't good enough for you, so you rip off the static machine? You've got some nerve.
And you are again? I'm sorry, you all look alike here. I don't know who the hell you are.
Who are these people? Huh? Are they Team Snagga? And what do they mean by traitor? Dark, you mean?
That's right, pretty lady. He's from Team Snagga, just like us. But he's no ordinary trainer. He's a snagger. He's the best in Team Snagga, my snagging Pokemon without fail.
No way, is that true, Dark?
This is so pathetically pointless.
Oh, so it is true. That's a little shocking.
Hey, Dark, come on, hand it over. Get back the snag machine you ripped off from the hideout.
How about no?
Snag machine? Dark, do you really have something like that?
The snag machine is built for trainers. When a trainer puts a snag machine on, their Pokeballs are converted. Ordinary Pokeballs are turned into snag balls that can steal Pokemon from trainers in battle. Hey, you blabbermouth, keep that stuff secret.
I get it, Dark. That's why these creeps are chasing after you.
Creeps? What do you mean by creeps? God, this is getting us nowhere. If you won't give it up willingly, we'll take it back by force. Try it.
Four fish in a coffin, yeah? Alright. I kinda don't mind four fish, but coffin, oh my god, I freaking hate coffin. But the Numbeon and Espeon still in tow are only two Pokemon. For the longest time, I'm gonna guess. I'm gonna fight a four fish and then use confusion on coffin because poison dies to psychic. Who would have thought? But the power of mind would kill poison. That blows my mind. And sort of like Threads of Fate with the minor voice acting for character leads back there. Unlike Threads of Fate though, I'm not asking for outside assistance for this. I'll be doing every voice myself! It's gonna be a killer on my voice. Then again, I do want to be a voice actor in the future. Color me shocked. I didn't know I wanted a set music in my future. And again, you know what? I'm gonna use Secret Power. I haven't used that yet. I'm gonna use Helping Hand. Because I never use these moves and people will probably beg me to show them off anyway, so why the heck not? It's midnight. I've honestly lost my mind. Oh hey, secret power. And Gorfish fainted by being stabbed, I'm guessing. Pathetic Whackin'. No! I'm not good enough! Think? You're only judged by how good you are by the amount of money you give me by the time you lose. It works in the end.
Blast you, Dark! Don't think this is over! We're going to get the snag machine back, just you wait! Try as you might, you won't get it.
Well, what do you know, Dark? So you're from Team Snagging. Oh, wait, to be accurate, I should say former Team Snagging. It's okay, Dark. It doesn't matter to me who you are. After all, you're my gallant friend who rescued me when I was in trouble. So it doesn't matter. Besides, I thought of something after listening to those creeps. Listen, Dark, we should go shopping for some Pokeballs.
You know what? Since we do have a snag machine on our arm... On our left arm? Yes, that's left. I think. Yes, that's left arm. Since we have a snag machine on our left arm, why not? Let's go find some Pokeballs. Because if what Roy says is true and there are some peculiar Pokemon out there, we could be very well helping people. I guess. I don't know. Because Roy is a little crazy. Potion, Super Potion, Antidote, Burn Heal, Ice Heal, Awakening, Paralyze Heal, Fall Heal. Why is there no Pokeballs? That should be like a standard for every market. Ever. And speaking of super potions, I can use more of them. I can use about 10. Throughout most of the game, trust me, I'll just be buying super potions because of their cost effectiveness.
So essentially I gotta go back to the outskirts stand where I was earlier, where I fought that one dude with those two zigzag goons. Awesome! I mean, why not? Let's not waste our time and go back there instead of just having them here in every shop available.
Who would've thunk it?
I mean, it would be more cost-effective if they did that. Then again, who cares? I'd like the outskirts stand anyway. It's a nice, desolate place in the middle of nowhere. And now Roy takes up the sidecar and must unlike our Umbreon and Espeon. I like Umbreon and Espeon. And Billy's probably shocked to see, oh hey, we got a girlfriend now. And it's about 15 minutes in. And let's at least get the Pokeballs and then call it a day. Listen, pal, if you're intending to travel somewhere, you might want to stock up on supplies here.
Hi, can I ask you something? Don't you sell any Pokeballs?
Huh? Pokeballs, you say? There's no call for those things around these parts.
Where do they put them now?
Oh yeah, here they are. A little dusty, I'm afraid, but otherwise perfectly usable. Here, take these. I'll let you have them for free. We got 5 Pokeballs, which would be absolutely useless. Well, since I found them, I may just put them out on the rest of my merchandise. If you need some more, well, how about buying them from me? Are you willing to buy something?
Sure.
Give me all them Great Balls that I can afford, man. And now I'm broke. Nope, I'm good. Okay, so I'm gonna head outside the outskirts stand, and then I think we're gonna call it a day. We got some battling done. We ended up buying some Great Balls, and bit of forewarned notice, I'm going to be using the ball switching unlimited Great Ball or Ultra Ball trick like I used in my regular Let's Play. I'm going to be using it a lot, so be used to seeing me go into that menu during the battles quite a bit. So anyway, next time on Let's Play Pokémon Colosseum, we're going to head back to Phenac City. See you all next time.